recognized by the government. IIT is always aiming at growing inclusive knowledge society. We work for connecting the unconnected. We are committed to social justice, industrial development, enhancing human resources in the field of information technology and telecommunications. For the last 4 or 5 years, we have been concentrating on two very important themes which this nation needs. Number one, rural development through the use of ICTs. Number two, environmental technologies, green technologies, how they can help in the overall scenario of this time. And when we were there last month in Ahmedabad, where we were deliberating on rural development, an idea came that we must speak on environmental technologies also. And that is how today we decided that we shall have this theme. It is not that for the first time we are deliberating on it. We have been discussing green technologies because in our annual convention also we had the theme green telecom. We feel that rural development and green technology are interdependent. Why we are pursuing rural development? Because we feel if we can give them the facilities, then the population migration from rural to urban India can be reduced. We don't say that people should not come from the city, but there are certain reasons for which they come. If we can provide them some facilities through the use of technology, definitely it can be reduced. And when it can be reduced, environmental conditions in the cities will definitely improve. That is the thing. Today, friends, it's a matter of great privilege for IIT that an eminent person, Dr. Ashok K. Chauhan, is here with us and he is our chief guest. मैं बैठा हुआ ये देख रहा था, जब सोच रहा था कि कैसे बोलूंगा, क्या बोलूंगा डॉक्टर चौहान साहब के बारे में, मैं तो यही देख रहा हूँ कि हमारा ये हाल छोटा पड़ रहा है, मुझे इसमें बातें नहीं करवानी पड़ेगी। पहली बार मुझे ऐसा एहसास हुआ है डॉक्टर चौहान के आने से कि ये हाल दिस स्पीक्स योर पॉपुलैरिटी टू एजुकेशन in the private sector in the modern India. Friends, few months back I was listening to Madam Irina Bokova. She is Director General of UNESCO. She was speaking on the occasion of Silver Jubilee celebrations of IGNO, where her topic was education development, world scenario. And there she gave the slogan that in the year 2010-11, UNESCO has given the slogan education for all. And when she says education for all, she made it very clear that our aim is not ke 10 pass kar liya, 12 pass kar liya aur padhai ho gayi. No. She said that in education for all, our main objective should be train our teachers also. There is a great shortage of teachers as it is in India, worldwide, particularly in the developing countries and underdeveloped countries. And then she says, skill development so that people can get work. This is another area, and these are exactly the conditions in India. And then she went on to say that Indian conditions, Indian model can very well be followed by other countries of the world. And she made a special mention of IGNO in the government sector, which is pursuing non-formal education, and she made a mention of MIT University, that private sector also has to come and stand so that education can be. I have been watching MIT group of institutions under the leadership of Dr. Chauhan, which has started from scratch, and today every student has a desire that if he gets admission in MIT University, nothing like that. मेरे पास काफी स्टूडेंट्स आते हैं, कैसे पास से आते हैं, ऑफ कोर्स आई डोंट नो एनीबॉडी इन एवरीथिंग, nor I approached them. But it indicates that how these institutions have grown. And government alone cannot fulfill any dream, whether it is industrialization, whether it is education, whether it is networking. So private sector, the show, path shown by Dr. Chauhan, who is an institution builder, I will again say, is great. And IIT feel proud to have him as our chief guest today. Friends, please join me to give a big hand to Dr. Chauhan. Thank you. NIT University is not new to us, nor IIT.
Four times. I've been traveling a lot. Why I'm telling you that? In between my wife one day, came into a cinema last week. And it's a good cinema, but it's very restless. She said, what's happening? What are you looking for? I said, where is the seat belt? And that's why I got conditioned traveling. Used to say, I think I see the task of saving the planet has been entrusted to me. And why I said the seat belt? You may have to wear first 5 minutes seat belt. I'll be rushing through. This may be academic, but I'll give you a background. It'll be very fast, then I'll go a bit slow. The topic I'm going to give is called, because I'm a green man and they are engineering, green engineering. Green engineering through human engineering. I think these two words are important. I think Mr. Chauhan is here. We can all form a kind of an alliance and do our bit. I just start my presentation. All of you must have been given a handout.
No.
And kindly fill in that tab slip. We'll put it on the mailing list. I just start my presentation. So let us quickly go to problems. Some of you already know it, some of them may not know it. 2020, you know, why all this global warming? I asked 2020, the students say cricket. But I wish they like Abdul Kalam, India is a great nation. In reality, 2020, you will have only half the food you are getting now. It's not just some kind of astrology. Because, you know, every day a new tribe is emerging called environmental refugees. It's all due to global warming, all of you know, it includes atmospheric warming, soil warming, sea warming, wind warming. I feel all due to mind warming. I always talk about inner climate change, which is not the outer climate change. And polar caps are melting, this picture was seen in many places. And the polar bear is going to extinct, become extinct and cease to exist. Antarctic. In Chennai, the joke is somebody wants a plot near the sea. The broker says, better you buy it in Kanchipuram, 50 miles, the sea will come there. So this is a danger we are facing. And atmospheric warming leads to inundation of farmland by sea, and we lose food, precious land. And soil warming, I don't know, in Anna, I was doing soil warming, same land, same toil, same sea. We'll have only 10-20% less food output. Sea warming is sea. 90% of people eat still fish. We'll get less fish. And this all causes wind warming. So wind warming, you know, uproot trees, fruit-bearing trees, and damaged crops. And biggest danger I see, according to me, are loss of farmlands. You will change your balcony, Delhi, Dharma, that is costing you. But easily you can convert your farmland into a beautiful gated community center. NRS will never come and sit here. And these are the photos I've taken. And of course, Indians won't keep quiet. The population will gallop by 2020. And peak oil, these August Aryans, I don't want to say today, the oil price is again going up. The peak oil means oil production is expected to test the highest ever in a few years. And the moment it happens, the increase, even marginal increase in the oil price will result in what you call the oil production. Lesser production of oil leads to escalation of oil price. This is due to peak fertilizer, because still from petroleum chemical only you get for fertilizers. The bloodshed, water, earthquake will be there. One of the reasons for earthquake is, I want to say, it's global warming. The water belts, it goes to the lowest grade of the sea, causes pressure there. And the pressure is more than 8 Richter scale, you have a tsunami. These are the problems we are having. Tsunami, all these pictures were seen it. So nation's problem, poverty, already this, you know, 2011, people suffered from poverty. And what will happen? See, even a great country, I always say, country is known for patience, Japan, India, and UK. UK, what happened, you know, Britain was burning actually. People today is going to be the order of the day. And there are many reasons, and local perils, air pollution, water pollution. The statistics say, every 5 seconds, India child dies, not consuming poison, drinking water. What will be the fate of water by 2020? I leave it to imagination. It's a public tap. So there are solutions which I am going to talk plastic. You can see the bird, what it has inside its stomach. They burn plastic, man lives in stone age, metal age, now lives in garbage. And there are so many other problems, I am just skipping that. These are some of the photos. I should not, you know, since it's my own home state, this photo taken from the water bodies there. And now, what we have to do, I want to say, I hope this institution, IIT, give excellent education. We can align, I'm going to show the solution now. The students learn, they will be contributing something to protect nature. Same time, there is a premium candidate when they go for higher study. There's a book called What They Don't Teach in Harvard University. Probably what the university don't teach, because by trial and error, what we learn, we are going to share with you. So these are things students will learn. Energy saving, waste minimization, conservation, waste to wealth, carbon neutral homes or places, home farming, collective farming, seed farming, sea farming. All these things, I myself doing it. I'm going to quickly show. Many underserved people are doing. I'm showing you what I am doing. I introduced collective farming in 3 districts. We take 1,000 acres because farmers are losing interest. They feel farming is no more lucrative. And to encourage it, we need to modernize, mechanize. So unless the holding is large, so we say remove the burns in the mine, you know, the burns in the land will disappear. So we have done it. I'm very happy to inform our collective farm in Mysore has been written, described one of the leading Tamil weeklies. It's as good as Reliance Industry. That's what they written. I got a very good news. I want to say we have a scsc.coin, you can see the website. We are aligned with all the service clubs who take up a village like Rotary Lines, all the clubs. So I want to address this work too for this part of the IET. You can change, you know, we have changed some 23 villages in a matter of 3 months' time. So here this is city farming.